Hi everyone, welcome back to today's video. Long time no see-ish. I never know what to say because you aren't really seeing my face, but I feel like it's been a long time and that's the right thing to say. I don't know. Anyways, hi, hello. It has been so long since I filmed a video and I am so excited to be back doing it. You have no stinking idea. Yeah, I am so excited. Anyway, so with that being said, I am in a new craft room, a new setup. This is the first time I'm filming, so if the lighting is a little off or, I don't know, just technical video stuff, lighting, all of that good junk. I keep saying lighting because I can't think of anything else. Bear with me. I will fix it. This is just my first time filming, and I was just excited to get a video out there and get it going for y'all. So like I said, it has been a little bit of a while. That doesn't make any sense. It's been a little while. That's what I'm trying to say. Since I filmed a video and since I've really been active with Little Moon Creation, there has been a lot of stuff going on. My life has changed quite a bit. And I kind of did a very high level, broad blog post, just kind of getting it out there, what's been going on, what I'm doing to kind of move forward. So if you want to read all about that, you can go to littlemooncreation.com and see that. But really, I'm not going to get too much into it here. I am just going to jump into this new project. I will say that I am really, really, really excited to get back into filming and crafting and card making. So you can expect to see a lot more from me. Right now, I am tentatively saying that I will be trying, my goal is to post a new video every Saturday, or during the weekend, I guess I should say. Maybe it won't be every Saturday. I'm gonna start getting a glare, I believe. We'll deal with it. But that is kind of my goal for right now. If you go and you read my blog post, right now I'm in this phase of my life where it's really about me, doing what makes me happy and doing what I want to do when I want to do it and kind of not holding back on living my life and living my life for myself. And so with that, there may be some times where it's a little bit more sporadic because I'm just doing stuff. I'm very, very busy. I'm going to be traveling basically every month from now until February, it looks like. And I just have a lot of stuff going on. So I'm going to try my very, very, very best and my very, very hardest to stick to a Saturday or weekend schedule. But please bear with me and forgive me if I don't stick to that 100%. I will do my very best, like I said. So anyways, enough of me rambling. Let's get into this project. So for today, I'm going to be showing you probably my favorite thank you card I think I've ever made. I don't know how I kind of thought of this idea or it kind of came to me one day, but I was like, you know, what if I just took letters and just cut them out and put them on a card base? And that's kind of how this card came about, and I absolutely love it. I have used this card so many times since I created this, and it's just amazing. So you can see I have a couple of different variations here. This one is one of my favorites. I don't know how well you can see it on camera, but it's just a white card base on a white card, or I'm sorry, a white piece of paper on a white card base with the words thank you cut out of it. I put some sequins here. I used the iridescent sequin assortment and some fine tip glue pen. You could very easily recreate this with using the basic adhesive backed sequins, which was my freebie for August, September-ish. If you don't know what I'm talking about, head over to littlemooncreation.com and check out my promotions on how you can get a free goodie from me every single month. My little self promo there. So you could do that. Those you just kind of peel and stick, and that would be super easy. This is kind of a little bit more time consuming. And then I did this version, which is utilizing, oh shoot, what is this paper? This is, hang on, I have my catalog right here. This is from the Woven Threads Designer Series paper. So I just put a piece behind it. This is going to be kind of what we're doing today. I'm not going to use this specific paper, but it would be the same exact process. Speaking of paper, sorry, I have so many like plugs I need to put in right now because I haven't talked to you guys in so long. I still have paper shares available. So if you go over to littlemooncreation.com/shop, that'll take you to my LMC store, which I'm currently running a promotion. Everything in the shop is 10% off using the code FALL19, and you can get paper shares. So I have tons of different assortments with the annual paper or the paper from the annual catalog, paper from the holiday catalog, tons of different options, different assortments, different price points. And like I said, everything right now is 10% off using the code FALL19. So if you're interested, head over there, check it out. But this is going to be close to what we're creating today. I'm just using a different paper underneath that. So to create this project, what do we need? The first thing is, and probably the most important thing, is the hand-lettered I don't know how to say that word, dies. This die set is one of my absolute favorites. I do not know why I am just now owning it. It is absolutely amazing. One of my faves. It's just a bunch of different letters. So that's awesome. That's number one. And obviously we're going to need our Big Shot, which I have over here off to the side. Next, you'll see I have like 18 different adhesives over here. So I have snail adhesive, tear and tape, and my fine tip glue pen. If you don't have anything else, if you just have one, I should say, I would say you need the fine tip glue pen first and foremost. I'm going to be using snail and fine tip glue pen and my tear and tape. You could get away with one. You could get away with two. It's really up to your personal preference. I just think they all kind of have their unique use for this project. So that's why I'm using all three, but don't feel like you absolutely have to. If you have to pick one, I would say use the fine tip glue pen, and I'll tell you why when we get into the project. Then you are going to need, so I'm going to use the Noble Peacock foil sheets for my underneath my thank you. These foil sheets look absolutely stunning with this card. Absolutely stunning. I've done this before. I used this in a few of my packages, my freebie packages, as thank you cards this month. And it just looks so pretty. So you just need a scrap of this. I think rough dimensions, let's look. Rough dimensions are probably 3.5 by 5.5. So not a super big piece. You could absolutely use a scrap, nothing crazy. This is gonna be too big, so we'll cut this down when the time comes. And then I have two pieces of white cardstock. So this is just regular Whisper White, and this is cut at 4 inches by 5.5. And then I have a piece of thick Whisper White. I use thick Whisper White whenever I'm using it as a card base because I just think it holds up a little better and it has a little bit more substance. And this piece is cut at 5.5 by 8.5 and then scored at the 4.25 mark. So let's go ahead and jump into this project. Okay, so I apologize for the glare in that last, in the intro. I opened the window that's in my room to kind of get some more natural lighting in here, and the sun's doing all kinds of weird things, so hopefully I can figure out the lighting and it's not too crazy. Trying to avoid opening my studio lights because they're just so big to store. I have like a corner back this way, not that you know what I'm talking about, but I could probably throw it in, but I'm just trying to not have to take them out. So sorry, hopefully the lighting's not too wonky. I will figure it out eventually, I promise. So to start off, I'm going to take out, my dies. And let me open this bad boy up. So I'm going to need all of the letters to spell thank you. And lucky for me, I should be able to relatively easy find them because I just had them out. Let's see. I need my H. Thank. Why are you? Perfect. Okay. So, and I still need that. Okay. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do this card vertical, whatever, this way. And I'm going to need a little bit of washi. So you can do it without washi tape if you want to. I'm not daring enough to do that because I'm also a perfectionist. So this is how I do it. You can do it however you want. You could just run it through the machine, your die cut machine, and call it a day. But this is how I'm going to do it. So I'm going to take my letters and I'm going to position everything in the bottom right corner. So I start with the U because that's what I want in the furthest. And then I kind of build out from there. So, mm-hmm. U-O-Y. And then the Y I kind of mess with because I like it to be a little bit higher, so that you get this piece. Oops, that one doesn't have it. So you get this piece down here and it really looks like a Y. So I scooch it up just a little bit to kind of get a little bit better of proportions for me, or for my liking, I should say. And now I'm gonna take a piece of washi, kind of measure it to that. Very important step, you want to put your piece of washi, if it's fresh, on your pant leg, on some kind of fabric, on a towel or something, to get rid of some of the sticky. I don't know if you can really see that. I don't even know if I'm in focus. Sometimes you can pull up a little bit of the paper and it gives that kind of like rough look. So just be careful with that. That's why I put the washi on something else before I put it on my card. So I put that piece down because I want those to stay where they are. And then I'm going to do the same thing with Thank. I'm telling you guys, I absolutely love this card. And it's so easy to do. Like, it seems like a lot of work right now, but it's really not. Once you kind of get into the groove of doing it, it's so easy. And it literally, you can crank these bad boys out in no time because you're just running the same dies through over and over again. And then you just put it on a backing and call it a day. Okay. So again, I have my piece of washi. I'm just going to put this, I'm putting it on the arm of my chair because it's fabric and it's right here and it's easy a few times to just get as much of the sticky off as possible. You really want to focus on the ends because that's what sticks to the paper. Everything else is stuck to the die and it doesn't really matter if it sticks because it's metal, so it doesn't really matter. Okay, so now I'm going to carefully pick this up because you don't want to move it too much because it's not like you stuck it down perfectly. There is a little bit of wiggle room there still. So, and I feel like I'm shaking the camera. If the camera is a little bit shaky, I'm sorry. I think I have my tripod too close to my desk. So if I'm moving my desk like at all, it's moving the tripod a little bit. So I apologize. I will fix it next time. I promise. Just bear with me for this one test. okay, so I'm going to put my piece on my cutting plate. I'm going to crank this through, maybe. Takes a little bit of effort. And then just for safe measures, I'm going to crank it back through. I don't really ever have an issue with this die not cutting all the way through with just regular Whisper White. I don't really ever have issues with it, but I always like to play it safe. And just in case, I like to do it twice. Move Big Shot out of the way. So I'm now going to take this off, and you want to be very careful when you take the dies off. The reason being is any of the letters that have the little inner parts, you want to save the letter and the inner bit because we're going to need those. So it is the A, the K, and the O, I believe. Oh, and the Y. I was like, I thought there were four. There we go. Pop that off. Pop that little guy. I'll just scooch him over there. The Y and its little bit. The O. And then the H and the N, I don't really need those, so we'll throw those bad boys off to the side. I can move my disgusting plate out of the way. And then carefully start to peel back the washi. Like I said, you just want to be careful when you're peeling this up. In the event that it's a little stuck, you can kind of wiggle it to hopefully not rip the paper. That usually works pretty well. So you want to just be careful and go slow. To make sure that you don't rip up anything. Especially on the edges here where the paper is really close to, or the die is really close to the edge of the paper, that's normally where I have the most issues. So just be careful in those areas. So you can see I have, I need the inners for my A and my O. So I'm just gonna pop this off and they come right out as soon as you release it from the washing. Okay. And then I can take out my U and my T because I don't actually need those. So these little bits here, I'm going to keep them, but I'm going to just scooch them off to the side for just a minute while we get this piece prepped and ready to go. So Now I'm going to bring in my piece of foil. And like I said, you don't need a piece this large. I just happen to have this as a scrap, so I just grabbed it. But I'm just kind of measuring it up to where I think it'll fit. Trying to grab some scissors from behind me. And I'm just going to cut it about here. I think that'll be good. Perfect, just like so. So the one thing that you do want to make sure is you want to make sure you have a nice straight edge on this piece. And I'm telling you, it really does make the biggest difference. So you can see on this sample that I have here, my patterned paper lines up perfectly with my thank you, my white piece of paper. And that just gives it a really nice look. If I didn't do that, it would look a little off. It would look a little wonky. So just keep that in mind for when you're putting this on there. So here's where we're going to start using the 18 different adhesives. I'm going to use some snail adhesive just for these little bits right here, because it's honestly just easier. That's really why. And I'm just gonna kind of put it on the larger areas, and this will help us get everything nice and stuck down. And then I'm gonna come in with my fine tip glue pen. And this is why I say if you can only pick one adhesive to use, pick the fine tip glue pen. Because what you wanna do is you wanna go into all of these little crevices where you have like these little tiny bits that kind of stick out and all of that kind of stuff. And you wanna go around basically every letter and just make sure that you have glue in all of the areas so that you don't have any kind of little bits that stick up off of your card. If it gets caught on something or anything like that, you want to make sure that it's really nice and stuck down. So especially like these little kind of bits that go in here, these little bits that go in and out from the letters, that's really what you want to focus on. Everything else you can kind of just get away with the snail, but it's really those kind of pieces that kind of poke around the letters that you want to focus on. That's where you're going to have issues with it lifting and it just not looking as perfect as it could if that stuff starts to come up. So now what I'm going to do is I find the easiest thing is to keep my piece flipped over and actually put my designer series paper on top this way. With the foil sheets, the one thing that I would say is just kind of give it a wipe. Make sure you don't have any lint or anything stuck down to it. And then I line up the corner of my designer series paper with the corner of the white piece, and it seems to give me a pretty nice look. Like I said, the main thing to focus on is to make sure this bottom edge is lined up. And then you just want to give it a good rub. Flip it over and you'll see that you probably have a little bit of glue that kind of seeps out. That's okay. I'm just going to grab a baby wipe and kind of wipe that up off of my desk. And then what I do is I flip this back over. And the reason I flip it over is to just see if there's a lot of glue seeping out from any of these areas. I don't see anything to be majorly concerned with. Sometimes you'll get a lot of glue that goops out and you just want to kind of, I use my little spatula here with this tool. What is this tool even called? I don't remember. I'll put it on the screen. You can use this or the other end of this has a little pointer. You also, there's another adapter that's like a ball and you can use this to kind of scrape off some of the glue. But I just kind of put this down and just give it a nice good push for about 10-ish seconds. And that just helps all of the little tiny pieces get nice and stuck down. And then you can kind of give it a look. Like my H here looks like I might need to give it a little bit more love. I first tried just sticking it down and saying, maybe have I not adhered all of the glue? And I just don't think that I put enough glue under there. So I'm going to take my fine tip glue pen again. And I'm going to use my little spatula here to lift it up just a bit. Pop a little bit of glue under there and then just gently push it down. And so this is where you normally get the seepage on the sides. So I can just take that, take my little spatula on the sides and kind of clean it up. It's not that big of a deal. You can't, honestly, you can't really see it unless you know it's there. I'm just kind of a perfectionist like that. So I worry about little things like that. But like I said, you don't have to be overly concerned about it because unless you're really looking for it, nobody's gonna notice. Okay, so we're almost there, you guys. We are almost done with this. Woo! Okay, so Now what we need to do is put our little inner bits into our A, K, Y, and O. And the easiest way to do this that I have found is to take the actual letter cutout, pop it back down in there, and then you want to take your inner bit, and this is where the this tool comes in handy. If I can find where I put the sticky part. The picker tool, I don't even know. Let's see. I have my catalog right here. Duh, Lindsay, you can just look in here. If I can find the page that has it. Take your pick. That's what this tool, I knew it was something. It has a sticky end to where you can pick things up with. And all I do is I'm gonna pick up the little inner bit. I like to use my little spatula end, and I'm going to put a little bit of fine tip glue. So I hold down my letter, I put just a little bit of the fine tip glue there, pick up the inner bit, and then stick it right down in there, and then I can just take the actual letter itself, and I'm gonna hold down the inner bit, and then you can take the letter itself and toss it to the side. And that way you know it's placed perfectly because that's where it would have naturally been in the letter because that's where it came out of. So I'll do that again with all of the other ones. So we'll start with the K. The K is probably the trickiest one I found. I think it's because the hole is so tiny that it's hard to kind of get it in there and peel the K away and all of that stuff. So I think that one is, this one's probably the most difficult, but it's not impossible either. So I just put a little bit of glue in there. I'm gonna stick this guy down. I'm gonna hold it down with my finger, and then I'm gonna find an area where the K is kind of sticking up. You kind of have to finagle it to kind of pull up the letter and keep the little inner piece down, but there you go. And honestly, you can just place this freeform also. Again, I'm a little OCD, so I think it just works better for me when I place the letter in there. Do a little bit of glue, pop in the piece, let it sit there for a second, and then pop out the letter. It just seems to work well for me. And again, once you kind of do it once or twice, you kind of get in the hang of how it goes, and it's not that hard. I will say that this take your pick tool is really, really handy for doing some of these little smaller pieces. It really, really, really works well. And there you go. So now all of our letters are good to go and our card is literally almost done, you guys. Like seriously, how easy was this card to put together? And it just looks so stunning. Like I can't get over how pretty this card looks. Sorry, I'm trying to put the pin back in my fine tip glue pin and I really had to concentrate, which meant I couldn't talk. Okay, so last step is to put it all together. And I just had, where did I throw my card base? What the heck, I just had it. Where did you go? Oh my gosh. You guys, my desk is not that messy. And I cannot find this card base. Ugh. I was kind of just throwing things all about, so that's probably my fault. Oh, here we go. Okay. Sorry. Whew. So, card base. I'm going to flip this bad boy over, and this is where I'm going to use tear and tape. Now, the reason that I'm using tear and tape is because of the foil paper. For this version where I didn't put anything underneath the letters. So I just took the piece of Whisper White and I put it directly on the card base. So I omitted that step where we put the foil down on here. I just put it directly on there and it gives it a really pretty look. If you're doing that, I would say you can absolutely get away with just the fine tip glue pen and maybe a little bit of snail. For this though, because you are putting an extra piece and the foil is a little bit thicker, I wouldn't be as concerned with just like normal designer series paper like I did with this one. It's pretty thin, so you can probably get away with just snail and the fine tip glue pen. But for the foil paper, because it's a little bit thicker, I'm gonna use snail just to make sure that it stays down really nice and pretty. So I'm just going to line the edges of this card, or of this base, I should say. And whoa, that's not what I wanted to do. Okay, sorry, my camera stops recording after a certain amount of time, so I had to turn the recorder back on. But you didn't miss anything. I'm still just putting some tape down. And then I'm actually going to use my little, my little poker on this bad boy to lift up the backings. So one, two, three, and four. And now I'm going to take my piece of cardstock and I'm just going to place this down. Just like so. I'm telling you, this is like one of my absolute favorite cards in the entire world that I've ever created. And then I'm gonna fold it in half. Use my bone folder to get a nice tight crease. And there you have it. That is our really, really, really beautiful, simple thank you card. I know I had someone, I posted this. Where did I post this? I think I actually sent this to a friend. That's what I did. I didn't post it anywhere. And they said you can see a little bit of the outline from where the paper is. And you can see it on this one too, because I didn't use a full sheet. You could absolutely use the same size. You could use a 4 1/2 or a 4 inch by 5 1/4 inch piece of designer series paper under this, but personally I don't think you can see it that much. I don't think it's that big of a deal where I would want to use a little bit bigger piece of paper. I think it's fine the way it is. But anyway, here is our finished card and a couple of different variations on it. I really, really, really hope you guys enjoy today's video. To get any of the products that I showed you today, you can visit littlemooncreation.com. Whoa, that's not where you're gonna go. You're going to go to, you're gonna go to littlemooncreation.stampinup.net, which that'll get you directly to my shopping page. To get any of these products. You can also go to littlemooncreation.com or click the link down in the description box below, which is the coordinating blog post that'll link you directly to all of these products. Everything on my website, I can't talk. See, it's been a while since I filmed a video, okay? Give me a break. if you go to my website, though, I have tons of promotions going on. Like I said, stuff on my personal store, stuff for Stampin' Up, my Stampin' Up store. There's a ton of different things going on, so make sure you visit my website. I have a whole promotions page where you can see all of the fun stuff that I have going on. If you have any questions, please feel free to send me an email. You can send me a message directly on my website. And if you need a catalog, I still have some that I'm sending out for free, so send me a message, an email, whatever, and or even leave a comment down below, and I will get one right out to you at no cost to you. So I hope you guys are having a great day, and I will see you in the next video. Bye!